Part 2 of our lesson on unit circle and circular functions covers finding exact circular function values on the unit circle. So just a reminder, we know the unit circle has a radius of 1 unit, and the circular function definitions tell us that x is the cosine of s, and y is the sine of s. So that means the x and y coordinates, as you go around the unit circle, the x coordinate is whatever the cosine of s is there. The y coordinate is going to be whatever the sine of s is there. So when we look at s is equal to 0, remember we're on the unit circle. We know this distance here, this radius, has to be 1. So then we know the coordinates of this point right here have to be 1, 0. So what that tells us, remember the x value is the cosine. So this means that the cosine of s equals 0 is going to equal the x value there, which is 1. And the sine of 0, remember this 0, we're talking about s being 0, is equal to the y value there, which is 0. Now here, s is equal to pi over 6, so we actually know what the x coordinate is going to be, because we know the x coordinate is going to have to be the cosine of s. Now we know that the cosine of pi over 6 is equal to radical 3 over 2, so that means that's what this x coordinate is going to be, radical 3 over 2. We know the sine of pi over 6 is equal to 1/2, so that means the y value of this point right here has to be the sine of pi over 6, because that's the sine of s, so that's going to be 1/2. Here, the value of s, which means the distance from here to here, is pi over 4. We know to find the x coordinate here, we just need to take the cosine of pi over 4, which we know is radical 2 over 2, so that's going to be our x value. We know that the sine of pi over 4 is going to give us our y value, so that's also going to be radical 2 over 2. Okay, so I would like you to go ahead and finish filling in the rest of the values all the way around the unit circle here. So pause the video and restart it when you're ready to check all the values. So go ahead and do them all, and then let the video roll again. The cosine of pi over 3 is 1/2, so that's the x value here. The sine of pi over 3 is rad 3 over 2, so that gives us the y value. When s is equal to pi over 2, we know the cosine of pi over 2 is equal to 0, and we know that the sine of pi over 2 is equal to 1. The cosine of s equals 2 pi over 3 is negative 1/2, and the sine of 2 pi over 3 is radical 3 over 2. Cosine of s equals 3 pi over 4 is negative rad 2 over 2, sine is positive rad 2 over 2. Cosine of 5 pi over 6 is negative rad 3 over 2. Sine is positive half. And when s is equal to pi, we know the cosine of pi is negative 1 and the sine of pi is 0. Cosine of 7 pi over 6 is negative rad 3 over 2, and the sine of 7 pi over 6 is negative 1 half. The cosine of 5 pi over 4 is negative rad 2 over 2, and the sine of 5 pi over 4 is also negative rad 2 over 2. For s is 4 pi over 3, we know cosine of 4 pi over 3 is negative 1 half, and the sine of 4 pi over 3 is negative rad 3 over 2. Cosine of 3 pi over 2 is 0, and the sine of 3 pi over 2 is negative 1. Cosine of 5 pi over 3 is positive half, and the sine of 5 pi over 3 is negative rad 3 over 2. Cosine of 7 pi over 4 is radical 2 over 2, and the sine of 7 pi over 4 is negative rad 2 over 2. Cosine of 11 pi over 6 is going to be radical 3 over 2, and the sine of 11 pi over 6 is negative 1 half. And hopefully you're noticing the symmetry that's happening as we go around the circle. We see, for example, the sine of pi over 6 is positive a half, and the sine of 5 pi over 6 is positive 1 half, because both of these points have the same y value, which is 1 half. Also using the symmetry, the x value here at pi over 6 is positive rad 3 over 2, and if we fold that over the y-axis and it lands over here, this point, at 5 pi over 6, it makes sense that the x value is negative rad 3 over 2. And you can do symmetries like that all the way around the circle. 2 pi over 3 and 4 pi over 3 are going to have the same x value. Both of them have negative 1 half as the x value, but their y values are opposites of each other. This one's positive rad 3 over 2, this one's negative rad 3 over 2. So you want to use all those physical symmetries as well as your knowledge of the trig function values, and that gives you your circular function values on a unit circle. Now this chart is something you're going to use over and over and over again this semester, so you want to be very fluent at labeling all the values for each angle going around the unit circle. So in this example, we're being asked to find the exact value of s in the given interval, and we'll be able to make good use of that circle chart we just made, filling in all the values around the unit circle. So in this first problem, we're told that we're going to find s somewhere between pi over 2 and pi. So we can label that on the diagram here. So that tells us that we're going to have to give a quadrant 2 angle somewhere over here, we know. We're given a piece of information about s. We're told that the cosine of s is going to be negative 1 half. Now, if we look at our circle chart we just made, since we're looking for the cosine of s to be negative 1 half, we know that that negative 1 half is going to have to be the x value. So when we look in quadrant 2 and we look to find out which value of s has an x value of negative 1/2, we see that that value of s is going to be 2 pi over 3. So that tells us that this angle right here is 2 pi over 3. Now, if you don't have that circle chart, you can still use your knowledge about reference angles. We know the cosine of s has to be negative 1/2. So what you also could do to solve this problem is think about the fact that the reference angle has to have a cosine of positive 1/2. We know all the reference angles, everything's positive. And we know using our reference angle chart, if we go in the cosine row and look for the value of 1/2, we see that our reference angle would be pi over 3. And if you start at pi and back up by pi over 3, then that's 3 pi over 3 minus 1 pi over 3 is 2 pi over 3. So that's a second way that you could solve this same problem. In this next one, we know that we have to be between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi. So that tells us that our angle is going to have to be in quadrant 4 here somewhere. We're told that the tangent of s has to be negative 1. So that means that when I take y and divide it by x, I have to get negative 1. So we're looking in quadrant 4 to find the value of s where the y value and the x value are just off by a positive and negative sign. And of course that happens at s is equal to 7 pi over 4. You could again have done this using a reference angle because you say, well, the tangent would have to be positive 1, right? Remember, with reference angles, everything's positive. So your reference angle for when the tangent is 1, you know, is pi over 4. 2 pi, you think of as 8 pi over 4. 8 pi over 4 minus 1 pi over 4 would be 7 pi over 4. So either using the circle chart or reference angles, you get to the same answer. Pause the video now and try these last two examples on your own, then restart to check your answers. Here, we know we have to be between pi and 3 pi over 2. So that tells us we're going to have a quadrant 3 angle. Since it's the sine function, if we're using our circle chart, we're looking for the y value to be negative radical 3 over 2. And we see that that happens at s equals 4 pi over 3. Or you could do a reference angle. You know if the sine has to be rad 3 over 2, that your reference angle has to be pi over 3. So if you start out at 3 pi over 3 and you add 1 pi over 3, you're going to end up at 4 pi over 3. So either way, you're going to get the same answer. And it's good to be fluent thinking in both methods, by using the unit circle or by using a reference angle. In this last one, we're between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi. So once again, we know we're in quadrant 4 over here. And we're told that the cosine of s has to be radical 3 over 2. If we look at our circle chart, we can see immediately that that's s is equal to 11 pi over 6. If we want to think of it in terms of reference angles, we can do that. And we think of the cosine is rad 3 over 2 when our reference angle is pi over 6. 2 pi, of course, is 12 pi over 6. So 12 pi over 6 minus 1 pi over 6 would give us 11 pi over 6. So you have two ways of solving these problems. Essentially, they're the same thing, but you're sort of approaching it using different methods.